Hello children, welcome back to 10th standard biology class. In the last class, we were discussing about sex determination in human beings. As already we have discussed, in some animals like reptiles, the environmental cues, the sex determination rely entirely on the environmental cues, means the temperature at which the fertilized eggs are kept decide whether the animal developing in the egg is male or female. And some animals like snails change sex. So here sex is not determined genetically, but in human beings sex is determined genetically. We have discussed already in the previous class, human beings have 46 chromosomes, means 23 pairs of chromosomes, out of which 22 pairs are autosomes, which do not determine the sex, and one pair of sex chromosomes they have. Males have one pair of sex chromosomes called XY, and females have one pair of sex chromosomes called XX. And males can produce two types of sperms. Just recall quickly, sperm having X chromosome and sperms having Y chromosome. But a female can produce eggs having X chromosome only, because female has both the similar type of chromosomes XX. Now, when the sperm having X chromosome fertilizes the egg having X chromosome, the resulting zygote will have XX combination and it develops into female child. And the sperm having Y chromosome fuses with the egg having X chromosome, the resulting zygote will have XY combination and the resulting child will be male. So this is how in human beings sex is genetically determined. Now we have also discussed about evolution process. What is meant by evolution also? Just recall, evolution is nothing but the gradual changes taking place in living organisms giving rise to new species or new organisms due to changes in their genetic composition is called evolution. There are many reasons for evolution. You will learn in the later topics. And you have also one such factor responsible for evolution is variations. Sometimes variations help an organism to survive, and direct evolution. Look at some variations may or may not help organisms to survive. We have seen two situations. Quickly recall. See, here is a beetle population. Imagine there are some red beetles in a population, and these red beetles were easily identified by the crows and they will be eaten up by the crows easily. And since sexual reproduction takes place, variations occur and a color variation arises. Instead of red beetle, one green beetle arises. Color variation arises, a green beetle is produced. It passes on its color to its progeny and it increases in population. And you can imagine now, you know that the green color resembles the color of the leaves, and crows cannot identify green color beetles on the green leaves, and they survive. So this green color, so that the red beetles only are eaten by the crows and green beetles survive and their population increases. So what can you infer here? Here the color variation helped the organisms to survive. And one more instance we have discussed. Among the red beetles, another color variation arises. A blue beetle is produced. Here observe, the both red and blue beetles are easily identified by the crows and both will be eaten up. Means here the color variation, blue color variation, does not help the organism to survive. And imagine another situation. Elephant foot written here. Try to understand. All of a sudden an elephant rushed into the bush and stamped on the bush. So that without looking at the colors, both red and blue beetles, beetle population is destroyed. But accidentally a few beetles survived were blue beetles. Here, the color blue will not help the organism to survive. Accidentally, by chance, some beetles survived. A very few beetles survived. Even though the elephant stamped the bush, both red and blue beetles killed, but a few blue beetles survived accidentally. So here it is accidental survival, not the blue color helped in the survival. And this is another situation. Suppose if there are more number of beetles, then elephant cannot make such a havoc, large or major havoc. When the beetle population is less, it may happen so, and very few beetles survive. That survived beetles were accidentally blue beetles. It is considered as accidental survival of the beetles. And whatever the color variation helped the organism in the first case to survive here, and their population increased. What we observe here, what started as rare variations became a common character in the population. So that what happened here, the color variation helped the organisms to survive, and their population, green beetle population, increased. Here, this which became the rare variation as it started and gradually became the common characteristic in the population. Here what happened, it changed the frequency of certain genes in the population. So frequency of genes changed over generations in the population. The same way in this case also, even accidents in small groups. Suppose the elephant, when it stamped, there were large number of beetles, then the havoc will be not so major. But in small populations, even the accidental survival also, or beetles also, what happens here? This accidental survival of the beetle population also results in change of frequency of certain genes in the population. So here the frequency of certain genes in the population change over generations. And one more situation let us, means I hope you have understood. Now in the first situation, color variation arise, they helped the organisms to survive. In the second situation, again a color variation arise, blue color beetle produced, but this color variation did not help the organisms to survive, but accidental survival. In both the cases, color variation and the accidental survival, means this accidents in small groups also change the frequency of genes, certain genes in the population over generations. Now another situation, if you consider, there are many beetles in a population and they are feeding on the leaves in the bush. What happened? In the bush, the plants suffered from a disease, plant disease, so that the leaf material available for the beetles became less, so that the weight of the adult beetles goes on reducing. So this continued over many generations, but the weight of the beetle, reduced weight of the beetles due to starvation. Starvation is due to plant disease. The leaves are destroyed, so that leaf material available for the beetles became less, and so that the adult beetles lost their body weight, and their body weight will continuously reduce. What happened later? When the adult beetles, when they lose their body weight, do they transfer this trait to their offspring? Never, because this body weight trait is not a genetic change here, only the change in the non-reproductive tissues, means the changes in the somatic growth is due to the change in the non-reproductive cells, or increase in the number of non-reproductive cells, or we call them somatic cells or body cells. So that due to starvation, the body weight is reduced and adult beetles gained low body weight, that is, there is no genetic change occurring here. Since there is no genetic change occurring, this trait, low body weight trait, cannot be passed on to its progeny. Over even after few years, many generations of beetles starved from leaf food. Even then, their low body weight cannot be passed on to their progeny. When the plant disease is eliminated, again plenty of plant food, leaf food they got, and again their body weight goes on increasing. Here it is not the change in the DNA or genetic composition. It is not at all the change in the genetic makeup. It is just the change in the body cells or non-reproductive tissues that will not be passed on to the germ cells, DNA of the germ cells. So here there is no genetic change occurring. Because of this trait, low body weight trait, cannot be passed on to its progeny. When once the plant disease is eliminated, when the beetle populations get sufficient food, again their body weight goes on increasing, so that this will not be passed on to their progeny, since there is no change in the genetic makeup of the organisms. That is the acquired trait here. The low body weight is the acquired trait during its lifetime, beetle's lifetime. So that acquired traits cannot be inherited by their progeny. So this is another situation where these beetle population starved due to lack of food due to plant disease. So that when the plant disease occurred, leaves destroyed and enough leaf materials were not available for the beetles, so that the adult beetles lose their body weight. But the young ones produced by the beetles, this low body weight character will not be passed on to the next generation, because there is no change in the genetic makeup of the organisms here. Now, just let us recall again what we have discussed so far. Variations may or may not help organisms to survive. I showed you the pictures there. Now, try to understand some examples. There are some beetles living in green bushes. They increase their numbers by reproduction. Crows can easily see red beetles. They are eaten by the crows during the reproduction. You already know that variations are more during sexual reproduction, and a color variation arises and some green beetles are produced instead of red beetles. The green beetles are not visible to the crows and are not eaten by them. Then gradually the population of red beetles decreases and the population of the green beetles increases. This variation has helped the organisms to survive. And the next example let us consider. During sexual, another I have explained you already, during sexual reproduction another color variation occurs in the red beetles and some blue beetles are produced instead of red beetles. Both the red beetles and blue beetles are visible to crows and both of them were eaten by them. Then the population of both red and blue beetles decreases. Here this color variation has not helped the organisms to survive. And I have explained you the accidental survival of blue beetles also. Again here color variation did not help their natural selection here. Blue beetles were selected by the nature and survived accidentally. In both the cases what happened, as I said, since genes control the traits, traits are controlled by genes, you have already learnt. The frequency of some genes in the population changes over generations. Now, acquired traits and inherited traits. I have already defined these two terms in the previous lesson. What do you mean by acquired traits? Traits that cannot be inherited by their offsprings are called acquired traits. These traits help an organism to adjust to their environment It is not the change in their genetic makeup. So these acquired traits are, you can say, lifetime experiences of the individuals which help them to adjust to their environment, and they cannot be passed on to their next generation or to their progeny. So acquired traits cannot be passed on from one generation to the next. I have explained you about the low body weight of the beetles due to starvation, that is due to a plant disease. So if the population of beetles increases and the plants are affected by diseases, the food, leaf material available for the beetles decreases and their body weight also decreases. But this decreased body weight beetles will not give rise to low weight or decreased body weight beetles, means this feature or trait will not be passed on to its progeny, because here genetic change is not occurring. If after a few years the availability of food increases, then the body weight of the adult beetles also increase and also increases. This is the acquired trait. The low body weight trait is the acquired trait due to starvation. This cannot be passed on from one generation to the next. Why? Because there is no change in their genetic composition or genetic makeup. There is no genetic change occurring. So it cannot be passed on to the next generation or to its progeny. So this may be asked for due reason. Write the points in your notebook. All these points are very important, and write in the notebook. Now let us learn what is meant by speciation. Speciation is nothing but, as the name tells, the process of formation of a new species from the existing ones is called speciation. Very important definition. What is speciation? It is the process of formation of new species from existing species. Now this formation of new species is due to many factors. What are the factors? The formation of new species from existing species is mainly due to one or more of the following factors. Already you know that variations help in the formation of new species. One of the factors is variation. Accumulation of variations, physical barriers like mountains, rivers, etc. when come between the populations, then these physical barriers, genetic drift and natural calamities, they are responsible for the difference in the characteristics. So that genetic drift, natural selection and migration are the factors due to which speciation occurs, means formation of new species occurs. What are the factors responsible for the formation of new species? Accumulation of variations, physical barriers, genetic drift, natural selection and migration are the factors which help in the formation of new species. Now let us discuss one by one. Accumulation of variations. You know what are variations, means differences in the characteristics between the individuals of the species are called variations. You have learned that difference in the characteristics of offspring compared to their parents, or you can also write the differences in the characteristics between the individuals of the same species are also called variations. And these variations accumulate generation after generation and a new species is formed. So the accumulation of variations over several generations produce new species. So this is one of the factors that produce a new species. And another factor is physical barriers. Which are the physical barriers? Population may get separated. Population may get separated by physical barriers like mountains, rivers, lakes, etc. The isolated groups produce variations. the isolated groups develop differences and variations so that they can produce new species. So here an example you can give is these red beetles. When genetic drift, if you think here, what happens here? A population of red beetles are there, or a population of beetles. When this population, group of beetles population, is split into two groups, into two separate groups, they can be considered as two separate independent species. Then when they split into two groups, they can be considered as two independent species. Here what happens when they are the neighboring beetles, they feed in the nearby areas and they breed among themselves and produce their offspring. Sometimes an adventurous beetle, from its place it migrate to another area, to long distance. It goes long distance, travel long distance, and there another local population of beetle will be there. With that local population, this migrant beetle breeds, and this migrant beetle's genes flow into the local population. So here the flow, gene flow, takes place between this migrant beetle and the local beetle population. So this results in a new species, formation of a new species also. And what happens here? Partially separated groups only, this can be possible. Or a crow can be carried, a red beetle, from one place and carrying it to distant place, and there without eating it, it may drop it in any other place there, and it breeds with the local population. So genes from migrant beetle flows into the local breed population, so that they produce another offspring with variations. So gene flow takes place here between the two populations which are partially separated. Suppose if a river comes in between these two populations, so that they are further isolated and they will have more and more differences, so that they cannot breed among themselves and produce the offsprings. Here natural selection helps in selecting the variation, so that the natural selection helped in selecting the particular variation which is powerful. Green variation sometimes may be selected, and that population may survive, and some other variation may be selected by nature, so that may happen in another group. It differs from group to group here, so that the new species is produced when the variations accumulate generation after generation, and gene flow from one species to another species, so that these direct evolution here. So physical barriers also help in the formation of new species. Now genetic drift, another factor which help in the formation of a new species is genetic drift. Natural calamities or introduction of new members of the same species in an area. Natural calamities or introduction of new members of the same species in an area produce changes in the gene pool of the population, and new variations are produced which can produce new species. So which can produce changes in the gene pool, so that new variations are produced and which lead to the formation of a new species. So genetic drift helps in the formation of a new species, which can produce changes in the gene pool, so that more variations, new variations are produced, which can produce new species. And natural selection, so only favorable variations or useful variations of the organisms will be selected by the nature and which can adapt themselves to their changing environment will be selected from the nature and they survive. So, how natural selection directs evolution? Only those individuals of a species which have useful variations and can adapt to the changes in the environment survive and the others die. So, those organisms which have useful favorable variations which can adapt to their changing environment can survive. That will be selected by the nature. The nature selects such favorable variations in the offspring or population and those organisms will survive and the others will die, which cannot adjust and which do not have favorable variations and which cannot adjust will die. The selection is made by the nature. These organisms can produce variations and a new species is produced. This survived organisms with variations, they can produce again more variations and they are responsible for the formation of a new species. Migration. Some individuals of a species may migrate to a new geographical area and adjust to the changes in the environment and there they develop variations and produce new species. So, some species or some individuals of a species may migrate to new geographical area and there they live and adjust to the environment there and develop new variations. In order to adjust to that environment, they develop new variations and they produce new species. So, sometimes what will happen, the changes that may be in their genetic makeup only, as I said, the beetle population when they are isolated, that isolated beetles in the isolated populations, they cannot breed among themselves because of more differences. Means frequency of genes change and there are more variations so that they cannot meet or breed with each other and produce their offspring. Means what happens here if the change is so drastic in the change in the chromosome number itself, then green female of one isolated group cannot breed with red male of another group so that they even when they meet also they cannot produce the offspring at all, so that a variation can be generated and a new species can be produced, so that the migration also responsible for the new variations development and responsible for the formation of a new species. So, which are the factors which help in the formation of a new species? There are different factors: accumulation of variations, genetic drift, natural selection, physical barriers and migration are the factors which help in the formation of new species. Now, what are inherited traits? Traits that are transmitted from parents to offspring are called inherited traits. What kind of traits are inherited? When there is change in the genetic makeup and the trait can be transferred to the germ cell, means that trait only can be transmitted from parents to offspring or from generation to generation. So, what are inherited traits? Inherited traits are the traits in an organism due to changes in the genetic composition and it can be passed on from one generation to the next generation, which results in evolution. So, what are inherited traits? Inherited traits are traits in an organism which are due to changes in the genetic composition and which can be passed on from generation to generation and which results in evolution. Let us try to understand the differences between inherited traits and acquired traits and the evidences for evolution in the next class. See you then. Take care.